For millions of fans, The Young and the Restless is still a must-watch. People have specifically tuned in for the past 45 years to see the antics and the outfits of Nikki Newman, played by actress Melody Thomas-Scott. In this week's Javel with Jamie, we sit down to talk to her about the drama on and off set.
Melody Thomas-Scott and I meet up at the most popular coffee shop in Genoa City, the fictional cafe that's often central to storylines on Young and the Restless.
I always do a welcome to Java with Jamie.
Oh, okay.
So thank you for joining me. Appreciate it.
Thank you for having me. Mm-hmm.
So right away with the Crimson Lights cups, you were saying these are hot ticket items.
They are at our fan club auctions. These are big. So if you behave yourself, we might let you have that one.
Cross my fingers. We are sitting in the Crimson Light Coffee Shop, which
we are.
For viewers of the show, this is a big deal. A lot of things happen in here.
Do you think so? Because I've always thought no good scene happens here.
Really?
I mean, a good scene in a soap is usually very dramatic or maybe some tears going on. That never happens in here. It's always like, oh, hi, how are you? And they come and pull out a chair and sit down. Talk. You know, it's fine, but I prefer a more dramatic scene.
No one gets slapped in Crimson Lights.
I was just going to say, I did slap Diane really well last year standing right here. That was good. So my theory is shot to hell.
And you are Nikki Reeves.
The one and only.
Drama is central to the show, where Scott's character, Nikki Newman, has been married more than a dozen times, been accused of murder, worked as an exotic dancer before becoming the first lady of Genoa City.
What has it been like to play Nikki Newman for all these years?
Oh, gosh. An unbelievable ride. How often does this happen to an actor, that an actor would have the same job for 45 years? This is incredible, and it is such a blessing, and I've enjoyed watching Nikki go from, in the very early days when she was just a bratty kid from the wrong side of the tracks, through everything she's been through, up to even today. It's always changing. It's almost like playing several different characters under the guise of one, because she gets into so many different situations. So I never get bored.
Could we change that order to a vodka tonic?
On the show, viewers have also watched Nikki Newman battle her demons with alcoholism.
I have always enjoyed stories where Nikki is an alcoholic.
You have? Why?
I just find it fascinating. I love the dichotomy of her being a wealthy matron of the town, and yet she can fall so low, and which proves it could happen to anyone, and it's a slippery slope.
In real life, Scott is also known as wife, mother, and grandmother of five. While Nikki Newman's love life has had its ups and downs, always coming back to Eric Braeden's character, Victor Newman, Scott's real marriage has been steady with Ed Scott for nearly four decades.
I met my husband on this show. We have our children because this.
Well, that's, what is it like for people to realize you aren't actually married to Victor Newman? You're married to your real husband in real life. Do people get upset when they meet you?
And let me tell you something, Jamie. A lot of people do think we're married. But that's the nature of a soap. You know, you're in their living room every day for years and years, decades. And so you become a part of their family, and they look to you as a family member. They don't necessarily want to think that you're not really Nikki.
Edward and I are eager to do our part to carry on the proud tradition of the great American soap opera.
But the real-life couple just received the Lifetime Achievement Award together at this year's Daytime Emmys, with Ed working as an award-winning producer for both The Young and the Restless as well as The Bold and the Beautiful.
One doesn't walk around town thinking, gee, I wonder if I'll ever get a Lifetime Achievement. You just don't think that way. So when the Academy told us, we were absolutely floored. I almost fell off my chair. But an incredible honor.
You seem very humble.
I am oddly humble, yes. It's, I guess I was raised that way, and it feels very weird to me if I have to say something good about myself. Not that I don't believe that I have many good qualities, but I'm uncomfortable with touting my own, you know, tooting my horn.
Why is that?
I don't know.
Just part of who you are.
I'm not in this business to get accolades. I'm in the business because I love it. And I need to do it every day to be happy inside. And that is good enough for me.
In her book, titled Always Young and Restless, My Life On and Off America's Number One Daytime Drama, she details the abuse she suffered as a child at the hands of her grandmother, who raised her, as well as men who took advantage of her. Scott says playing Nikki Newman since 1979 has been healing.
What brings you joy in this job?
The people. The being able to act every day, as I just said, to be able to take a script every night and turn the page into the stage and make it as real as possible. I love emotional scenes. There's a great release about crying in a scene, and you can lose yourself in that emotion. And then the scene is over, and you walk away, and you're not sad. Only Nikki was sad. That's another thing. You have to really separate that. You cannot bring your job home if you're on a soap.
Before wrapping up, Scott takes me through the set, where I can picture so many storylines and scenes over the years.
What do you think it is that has kept soap operas relevant?
A daytime fan really gets immersed in it because you're there every day. No question about that. And it's a time for them to take a break in their day. If they're working, they're rushing around with their children. Oh, now I can sit down for my hour and watch my story. You know, they like to call it their story. And I get it. And we have so many fans who are fans because their mothers every day would sit down for lunch on the sofa and watch our show. And of course, the little ones are sitting there too, watching. Shouldn't be, but watching.
So I have a confession to make.
Oh, God.
So when I was a little girl, my mother and I used to watch Young and the Restless all the time together.
Oh.
And she one day asked me, what do you want to be when you grow up, Jamie? What are you thinking about? And, you know, a doctor, a cartoonist, a comedian. And she said, well, I just want you to know you can be anything you want to be in the world, including a soap opera actress like Nikki Newman.
Oh, my. Which she rejected entirely. You probably thought Nikki Newman was a real person.
I did. Who lived in Genoa City, Wisconsin.
Yes.
And I grew up in Minnesota, so it's,
right.
It's not that far-fetched.
Right. Well, your mom had a good idea there, but I don't know where you went wrong.
Oh, we had such a good time together. She goes by Mel. She does not go by Melody. She does not like her first name. She
good
went to college for music, and she said it was just too cliche
she
for her.
She was so cool to listen
She's
to.
She's awesome.
Yeah.
We really had a great, great time. She even suggested maybe I could come on and play her long-lost sister, which I hope the writers are listening. Because
that would
be
amazing.
A blast.
What did you do to her to make her slap you?
Oh, I asked her to. Actually.
Oh, you asked
yeah,
her to. Okay.
We kind of threw that in there
a little bit to see
if anybody was paying attention.
Did
but
it hurt?
Isn't that the best part of a soap opera is when they get so dramatic and then they... So she taught me how to do it, how
so
to swing
cool
my
to
face.
See, though. I mean, so many of us grew up watching her and watching these soap operas and all that kind of stuff. And to see that she's still doing it and passionate, amazing.
Yeah, she loves her job,
which
I think is great.
And you shot it at the coffee shop of that soap opera, right? I'm like, that looks like a nice coffee shop.
But I didn't behave, so I didn't get a mug.
That's why you got slapped.
Exactly.
No, she seems cool. That was a good story.
Thank you.
Yeah.